If you feel sad when your clients ask you for a pink and white and you are struggling with creating crisp and perfect smile lines, in this video I will show you one of the easiest ways in the world to create it using PolyGel. My nail is already prepped, don't worry about the white lines, those are experiments. I am applying dehydrator, wait until it dries and then apply non-acid gel primer. And once it's applied, I will use Cover Pink by Gelish, and this is my favorite part. Squeeze and slice. I'm taking the medium size bead and put it right on the nail closer to the cuticle, and then with a synthetic brush and a little off-slip solution, I first start working near the cuticle area. If you haven't seen my previous tutorials on PolyGel, I will leave the links in the upper right corner. So it's just my opinion, it's easier to start with the cuticles. So make sure it's completely thin and there should be always a small gap between the skin and the product. And if you accidentally got some product on the skin, just take an orange wood stick and remove it, or there might be lifting. Then I'm working near the cuticle area and stretching the product closer to the free edge. So my goal now is to create the reverse smile line. This is the main part of creating smile lines. So the better reverse smile line you create, the better it will be in the end. And obviously there's not enough product right now on the left side and in the center. So I was wondering if it's possible to actually add some product. Let's find out. So I took a small amount of PolyGel, put it right on the top. My brush is in slip solution and first I'm stretching it up. I'm basically working the same way I will work with acrylic if I was adding something. And yes, seems like there's no difference in color already. So yeah, you can add up before you cure as much as you want. And now I continue working creating the smile line. Make sure that it's crisp, that it's even. The central part of the smile line should be the thickest one, and in the corners it should be thinner. Make sure they are on the same level, they are sharp and crisp also. Now I'm working on the surface as well, but at some point you just need to stop, as you can basically fix this product forever, and then I will cure it in LED for 30 seconds. Then I'm taking bright white and my favorite part, squeeze and slice, and oh, this white looks so good, it's actually matte. Okay, then I place it on the nail and honestly, I already like this look. So then I will work with my synthetic brush and start to stretch it, and it's already obvious I took too much of this white, but I will show you how to fix it later. So first I will stretch it to the corners of the smile line, and right now it actually looks and feels like I'm working with acrylic in its proper consistency. The only difference is that I have all the time that I need. And on one hand, it is an advantage, like take your time. It's perfect, I think, for the beginners. But on the other hand, when there's just too much time, I think it might be bad. I mean, you know, the service might take longer, but I think it's all come with the experience. The more you practice, the faster you will be able to work with that one. So make sure that the white is stretched and completely connected to the pink part. The corners of the smile line also should look crisp and sharp, and there should be no gap between the pink and the white part. So now let's take a look. I'm cleaning and the nail is too long now. So I'm taking my metal spatula and simply cutting off the rest. It's so simple. And then I'm fixing the edge with the brush and a little bit of slip solution, and then I will cure it. So 1 minute was not enough, so I cured it for 90 seconds, but that's probably because my lamp is not as powerful as Gelish. Now I'm filing it, and honestly, I don't like filing, but with PolyGel it's okay because it's really soft and it just takes me a few minutes. So I'm filing the surface first and then I will file the shape of the nail. And when I'm done, I only need to buff it. So I'm using 220 buffer, making sure the surface is nice and smooth. Then I will remove the dust, clean it, and apply the top coat. So as poly gel is gel, do not forget to also cap the free edge and the sidewalls, especially if you are doing natural nails overlay. And this is the result. So my conclusion is poly gel is really easy way to create a crisp smile lines. As with any new product or technology, you just need to practice for a while and feel it. So for clear enhancement for one color, I can definitely admit that it took me way less time rather than working with acrylic because it files so fast. But with pink and white, I'm working with acrylic faster, but that's because I'm working with acrylic for 13 years already, and this is just my second pink and white. What are your thoughts on this issue? Would you replace poly gel with acrylic or gel, or simply add it as an additional service? Please share in the comments. I would love to read them. Thank you so much for watching this video, and I'll see you in my next one. Bye!